We have our mission, we have our core values, and then we're going to talk about our conflict norms next. After that, this was a new thing for us, but we created guiding principles. And this is all those things that are kind of talked about within an organization, but so often people forget to write them down. And we just created a list. It was 30 items. And one of them, please say it. It's my favorite thing you say. What is it about the price, Tricia?
Oh, the price is the price is the price.
That's right.
We believe in the value we bring, and we don't like negotiating. So the price is the price is the price, and we know why it is. And we have other things like that, like no gossip. We don't tolerate gossip because one bad apple spoils the bunch. So there's certain, to Lisa's point, we have a lot of them, but there are certain kind of guiding principles, if you will, that we live in and die by. Because they answer the questions our team has, and they make it so clear.
Right. And there are things that this is really where we started to notice those gaps, is that one team talked about it a lot, but the other team didn't talk about it as much because there's a variety in responsibilities for your team. So, for example, the price is the price is the price was something that was absolutely clear to our sales team and to our client relations team, but maybe marketing, because they're not dealing with the customers all that often, maybe they just didn't know about it. And so then they would have questions. Well, why aren't we doing this or that? And so it was, as an organization, it was all of us getting on the same page. And when we actually communicated them for the first time, there were some people, to kind of our embarrassment, who were like, I've never heard this before. I'm like, what do you mean? You've never heard
I know. That. We actually had a new manager go through training, come out of the other side and say he hadn't heard one of our guiding principles before. So we knew we had a gap in our training, and now we don't.
Yes. And it was a great iterative process where we literally took all of our leadership team, right? And we sat down and we said, send us some of yours. And they were very, very different. But then those 30 was the common theme that was kind of weaved throughout this. So this was a multi-week process of meeting with our leaders and really coming up with that list of 30. And here's the thing. I'm going to give everybody permission. It does not mean that these are going to be the same 30 today and 10 years from now. Like, give yourself permission if you create these for things to change, because your business is going to change. The last thing you want is to have a bunch of antiquated guiding principles 10 years from now because you created them. It's kind of what we say about our mission statement. It's not there to collect dust on the wall.